Hey.
Dear comrades around the world, to give you our current circumstances, it's 4 a.m., we're somewhere in the middle of British Columbia, we're on a train, it's a tiny cabin. The rest of the train, which includes 10 bands, the manifest includes 10 bands of various numbers of members.
And then there's like freedom fighters / independent musicians all over the place, independent photographers, independent documentarians, and there's like 10 official documentarians. Sometimes you're like watching someone play music and there's 4 people with cameras around them. It is something else. And then we're confined to this space where it's like, someone said it earlier, it's a straight maze. And you walk through these tracks and these trains, and it's definitely a little bit claustrophobic for some. If you're claustrophobic, this is not a place for you.
Yeah, we walked from end to end of this train, yeah. and there's all sorts of different cars that are stuck together like various Legos, right? And there's like the dining cars, the activity cars, the cars where nobody's sitting, but there's an awesome trippy roof where you can see everything. The sleeper cars, we can't see anything, but at various times there's people that tell us various rules. Don't drink here, don't do that there, you're being too loud.
And it's not very rock and roll. It's funny, they have like this bullet point thing where they have to go through. They're like, they say these things, and then like you can tell they're just saying them because that's their job to say them. You
know? They don't really believe them.
Well, yeah, in their heart of hearts, but they're like, oh, I have paying customers here, I gotta make sure that they're happy. And they're right, but at the same time, it's, you know, you invite all these fucking bands and crazy
you
people
can't,
on the train. Yeah. Like, you can't really. Yeah, you should just stuck them in one end and just done your thing.
Well, we're here on this Tracks on Tracks trip, right? And I thought that all the bands would be sort of stuck on a couple extra bonus cars.
Mm-hmm.
But it turns out we're spread all over the train. So there's, like, various rock and rollers spread out from car to car to car to car to car.
And they're funny, too. In the beginning, I remember, like, and I talked to a couple of them about it. It's like, they all felt super awkward. Like, should I introduce myself to all the other musicians? And it's like, it's funny because, you know, Dave and I are pretty outgoing kind of characters, but these folks, like, they make music and they make magic and they make people smile and make people happy, but they don't really, like, they don't have the same kind of belief in, like, opening up and saying hello to some people, like, you know. And then when the instruments come out, we're all friends and we all sing together, and it breaks down all the walls and we start to get to know each other and we talk, wax philosophical, but, like, there was that weird kind of initial awkwardness that was pretty funny and pretty cool.
And the train itself sort of augmented that weirdness, because for the first hour we were start, stop, going through Surrey and Port Kells and
Coquitlam. It took like 2.5 hours to get, like, past the Hawkesfield Bridge.
Like a 45-minute drive, right? Just start, stop. And but then the magic really kicked in up in one of the domey cars, and we were able to witness some really remarkable musical collaborations.
The best was that, like, no one really knew people were doing really cool covers, and none of them really knew all the lyrics, and then, like, people would, like, speak up and pipe up and guide the lyrics the wrong way. Like, I was thinking, like, man, we need someone to sit here with all the lyric sheets and just, like, yell really loud.
We need a karaoke book for the Tracks on Tracks.
And then they went into originals, and that was
when it really took off.
That was serious.
So to warm, kind of get the crowd going and get the musicians going, there's been Beatles, Pink Floyd, Weezer. But then when Portage and Main played some of their originals, and Chris Ho, and Cody on banjo,
Ian Beavis. And Bear Mountain, and Topless Gaylove Techno Party.
Yeah.
Threw down, like, this folky, like, one-man band kind of thing, and it was cool. I took a couple pictures. There's like 4 like super high-end cameras like shooting him, and like a mic in his face, and it was just him and, you know, the rest of us kind of around.
Snuggled in sort of a train chair.
Yeah.
Right. None of this is designed for performance, but we're just sort of shimmying our way in.
And they had like documentarians on tables, and like just they're hopefully like it's. I worry about the editors because they're gonna have so many choices and so many options. Like, you're gonna have like this little weird performance that's gonna be like 20 seconds of the film. And you're gonna have 3 minutes of it, and you're gonna have it from 4 angles. And like, how are you gonna decide what to do and what's the pacing gonna be like? It's gonna be awesome for sure. That's the best part. But who knows what it's gonna be like?
Not only do the editors have mighty decisions, but we also do too. It's about 4:15 in the morning. And our first stop on this whole train trip, the first stop where the train actually stops, and there's a stop, period, full stop,
3 p.m.
is in Kamloops.
At about 6 a.m. I thought it was... Oh, yeah, yeah, okay, yeah. The coast goes open.
So do we keep on partying and hit it till 6 a.m.?
Well, and then breakfast, off. Too. So breakfast, they serve us breakfast, but breakfast is from 6:30 to 9:30. So, like, we're 10:30 weekenders, right? Like, we're trying to pretend we don't get up at 7 or 6 every day and, like, trying to sleep in a little longer. Like, it's basically, crazy. Yeah. So our whole plan here is, like, maybe we're just going to try and stay up or, like, kind of stay half up until early in the morning. And then we're going to have breakfast and then go to sleep until 2 when we get to Jasper. We get to Jasper at 3 o'clock. There's a couple bands going on, and I think that'll be the good times.
Yeah. Hit restock on ice. Restock on beers.
Ice and beer, yeah.
And a quick visit to the Dead Dog Saloon. And Jasper Tourism, who turns out our social media savvy, they're going to pop down and say hello. And, and then we'll see how we keep on going. But in the meantime, we got a groovy little room. Do you want to see a site? It's tiny.
It's pretty big. You can check it out. That's it. That's the wall over there. That's it.
Yep.
And we got a mirror there. And that's upstairs is another bunk. In the daytime, it converts into 2 chairs, which is pretty cool.
And then you're back to us. It's a pretty short tour around this room. So,
bon voyage.
Here we are. Soon. We are bon voyaging aboard the Via. And we're doing it with you in our wee little suitcases.
It is literally 7:30 on Saturday in Toronto. Peace.
Come on, everybody, know.
We're here at the third sitting of the luncheon here in the dining car on this exclusive and elegant Tracks on Tracks trip. Now, you may look at us and say, look at these guys, a little rough around the edges, look a little haggard, look at these. But really, we're really rolling this pretty sophisticated, you know? We're listening to the announcements. I think we're really doing a great job as passengers so far, although I suspect some of the staff would probably...
Beg to differ.
I think we're probably a C minus in some of the staff.
We may be being painted with the same brush as many people. Yeah.
Well, anyway, a few things that we've learned about the train so far, and this is
The beauty. I think you want to try and capture a little bit of that tilted up. just right as the trees come. Sorry about that. People.
All right, so we're it's about 1 in the afternoon or something like that on our second day, but it's already confusing. Less than 24 hours in, because we were up to like all hours. I think we rolled till we kept on rocking till about 6 in the morning, was it?
Yeah, I think we were the sun was coming up. It was very beautiful. We were trying to hold on for the sunrise, but it was cloudy, so we kind of gave up on that.
Speaking of beautiful, yeah. Say hello. Oh, say hello, yeah, to the internets.
How's it going?
Good. So this lovely lady, Adaline, was singing for us in one of the cars that I've lost track of. There's like park cars and there's skyline cars and
the upstairs car.
Yes, that one.
What's it called?
I have no idea.
The sky car.
I've lost track of them all. It was pretty nice though, singing, you know, because I heard the electronic music and then you're with the guitar. That was just lovely.
Yes, and today I'm going to do a more acoustic set. Today I'm going to do an acoustic set, and then tonight I'm going to do a electro set.
Well, I'm going to listen to it all. And you folks out there, continue your jealous rage. So, to go on with this, I think that
us as passengers here on Tracks and Tracks, we've gotten to know each other quite well, and we're doing a great job at that. I would give us an A on that. However, us getting to know the train rules, it's a little baffling, right? Like, it shouldn't be this fucking confusing to do anything on a train. There's a lot of rules, a lot of shakedowns. You got to be wearing shoes. And if you don't wear shoes, you are going to hear about it, hey? You get a lecture?
Get a lecture, same rules at home. You can drink at your house, you can't drink in the street, or bring your own booze to
the but it seems ridiculous because we're on a confined thing, right? Like, there's not too much we can do. So we're sort of trying to play friendly. I, of course, brought my own beer stein, which helps a little bit. I don't know why everyone doesn't bring a beer stein and soaked pajamas on a train trip. It seems sensible. And that wasn't on your packing list.
I feel stupid for not bringing those things.
Well,
sure.
You know, I brought an extra stein for you.
That was good. That's
yeah. Not quite as high end.
Oh, speak of the announcements.
Oh, yeah.
We have now arrived at another seated point of interest.
Oh, yeah. Point of interest.
So on the right-hand side of the train.
Oh, look at this. It's though you're on the train with us.
Lake, which is one of the largest lakes in the Canadian Rockies, being. Follow the shoreline.
Largest lake in the Canadian Rockies. We're going to follow the shoreline for about 8 miles or kilometers.
It has an average depth of 300 feet, but it is considered to be a bottomless lake. And with most significance, this is the headwaters of the Fraser River.
Oh, look at that. Headwaters of the Fraser River is bottomless and also 300 feet deep. Dude, it seems like an oxymoron. But again, as we're finding out on the train, everything's a little bit different. My favorite thing so far about the train, though, might be the shower. The showers are awesome.
Except
an endless hot
the train stops.
I gotta say, the beds, the ones we were in anyway, they like seem pretty basic. But when you get in there, it is cozy. Good for napping. Good for like quiet times. Good for the end of the night or the beginning of the morning, whatever happens.
Whichever one it was. And so last night in the Skyline car, besides Adaline, guys, Portage and Maine were laying it down. I love that.
Chris Ho,
the
original.
Ian Bevis, Bear Mountain.
Yeah, Ian Bevis threw down some acoustic folk music. We know him for his stint in Topless Gaylove Techno Party and Bear Mountain, very electronic focused music. But he has this, I don't know who to compare it to. He's kind of got that voice, that raspiness. I'm thinking of all the originals, and they all come to mind. So I don't really want to list off them all, but
yes.
You know Bob Dylan, Neil Young, Neil Simon.
You know, the huge, no big deal, right? No pressure there yet. And so as we as the train rolls on, we'll be enjoying many more various performances in various cars.
If we can figure out the time zones and the timing of the shows, because there's that whole thing going on too.
Yeah.
So. No, is it starting right now? It's 2:30.
See, that's what we need an announcement
for. I'm right on top of it.
There's going to be some music.
It's
you should
Adaline,
get your ass up.
2:30 in the party car. Yeah, and then at 3 o'clock, it's Chris Ho at the very end in the last car, the parked car. And then I think there's another thing in the Skyline car, but that's 8 o'clock.
Wow.
I think there's like some kind of station show. Yeah, it's
anyway,
like all kinds of music.
Anyway, for nice dinner. Six
all right.
Second,
all right, Daniel's back and he's got some questions for us. So I'm going to let you go. See everyone out there from Tracks on Tracks. Just keep on rolling, man. So Adaline, how are you doing on the train so far? We're halfway through. We're rolling through the prairies. How do you feel?
Yeah, I'm feeling like I've gone pretty hard the last 2 days. It's been fun. I don't think I really knew what to expect from the trip, but I figured it would be kind of similar to previous group musician experiences where it would just be a lot of fun, and it's been exactly that. Canadian musicians are pretty fun people, so it's been good.
Can you compare this trip to anything you've ever done before?
Yes, I can compare this trip. I think, you know, I was in the Peak Performance Project for 2 years, and it has that sort of family feeling. What's nice about this, and, you know, the Peak is it's a competition, and so sometimes you're in that mode, so this is nice because there's just absolutely no reason to compete here. It's just having fun and collaborating and getting to know other people. And a lot of these musicians I don't know, so it's been really fun.
Who have you collaborated with so far?
The first night I did a lot of singing with Portage of Maine. They were breaking out the hits. I did a little bit with that, and then I've been singing with, I really want to collaborate with the City New York girls. That's a goal of mine. They're somewhere here. And we are still to have our dance beat party. I'm going to do we're going to have a synth off with the topless people.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm going to take them on. I know there's 7 of them and 1 of me, but I feel that's the challenge maybe tonight.
You said you've been collaborating with, or singing with Portage and Maine. What were you singing?
Well, they're singing some original stuff, and I was just sort of, they're doing a Southern Souls video in Toronto in a few days, so I'm going to go and sing with that and do with them. And it's been pretty busy so far, so I feel like today and tomorrow it will be mostly when a lot of the collaborations happen, because I think we're just, the first day or two, you're just kind of getting to know people and getting a feel for everyone, but it's starting to feel like, we have recording software here. We have, so I'm sure we'll start doing some of that.
Can you tell me, you did a special performance yesterday. Can you tell me about that?
Is it bad if I don't remember the special performance?
films us every string.
Here on the Tracks on Tracks, and Cody is sending postcards out to all the folks, man.
Techno, 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 techno body, techno, techno.
sending these postcards to, Cody?
This one's going out to Rob Smith.
Rob Smith, he's
Vancouver.
A big blogger. He's a big blogger.
Yeah.
His name on the blog is I Am Rob Smith.
I Am Rob Smith.
Yeah, he's a good guy.
Oh, thanks for going.
And each of them written and stamped with love and affection.
Here we go. So this is the this is the postcard here. Jarrett Sitter original. Tracks on Tracks. Yeah.